am Donna Sharrett. I'm a Master Gardener volunteer with Cornell Cooperative Extension of Westchester. And I'm so happy to be here today with the Parks Department from the Village of Ossining. Village of Ossining was so lucky to get a wonderful grant to plant from the DC to plant 80 trees. And we're going to give you a lesson on how to properly plant trees.
Hello, my name is Miguel Marra, Parks Department Foreman, Village of Ossining. Soy aquí plantando árboles y por un préstamo que vino del DEC, del estado de Nueva York. So, we are excited about this.
And we're joined by
Spencer Thomas, Parks Department, ready to plant a tree.
Miguel Gregera, Parks Department.
Carlos Urgiles, Parks Department, ready to plant a tree. Beautiful day.
I'm Charles, I'm a volunteer, and I'm helping to plant the tree.
So, Miguel, what is the best gift you can give to the planet and to the next generations?
El mejor regalo que le podemos hacer al planeta y a las próximas generaciones es plantar árboles, ¿no? Los árboles van a estar aquí por mucho tiempo y lo vamos a ver nosotros y las próximas generaciones.
That's right. A well-planted and well-maintained tree is the best gift you can give the planet. So there's three things that you should consider when you're thinking about planting a tree. One is you want to have the right plant for the right place.
Plantar árboles de la manera correcta es muy importante. Eso es lo que va a hacer que el árbol crezca de la manera apropiada. Hay tres maneras de plantar un árbol correctamente.
The next thing you need to do is you need to properly plant it.
Plantarlo propiamente.
And then last and not least important, very important, is properly maintaining it.
La mantención después que se planta el árbol es muy importante, porque eso es lo que va a determinar de la manera que el árbol va a crecer.
So, we're planting a tree that's a bald and burlap tree. It's a larger diameter tree. It might be larger than most people do. The other opposite end of this spectrum is a little tiny tree that's been planted by seed. And then when you go to the nursery, you can always find things in between. So there's a little bit different techniques for each one.
Estamos plantando un árbol. El nombre de este árbol es un white gum. Y es un árbol que ya viene así, ya pronto para plantar con las raíces cortadas. Y después tenemos este pequeño aquí, que es un árbol pequeño. La diferencia es que ese árbol grande, las raíces fueron cortadas, y este árbol pequeño, las raíces tiene todas las raíces del árbol, ¿no?
So when you buy it in a nursery, it'll be bigger than this, but if you buy one in a pot, the problem that you could have is that the roots, if it's been in the pot too long, the roots will start circulating around the pot, and that if you were to buy that, you would have to try to either, if it's too circulated, you do not want to buy it, or if it's a little bit circulated, you want to try to straighten the roots out.
Cuando se compra un árbol pequeño así en una maceta de plástico o lo que sea, a veces las raíces tienden a formarse en círculos. So, cuando se va a plantar el árbol, lo que hay que hacer es abrir las raíces, asegurarse de que las raíces están derechas, porque eso va a hacer que las raíces se desarrollen en una mejor manera.
So with this tree, what's happened is they've dug it out of the ground and cut the roots. So the problem with this is it's lost a lot of root mass. So that the problem with that is that the difficulty with that is that you're going to have to just really watch it and maintain it, which we'll go over later. But that's you get a bigger tree, but you have a little bit more maintenance than with a smaller tree.
Cuando plantamos árboles así, este árbol ya estaba creciendo en el suelo, en la tierra, fue arrancado y las raíces fueron cortadas. Cuando se planta un árbol así, lleva más mantenimiento y más cuidado después de plantado.
So you want to get started?
Let's go. Let's do it.
Would you like to bring the walk over first, or you want to start unwrapping?
We're gonna unwrap it now.
Okay, so
vamos a hacer ahora, vamos a sacar todo el movimiento y lo vamos a después que lo tenemos abierto, vamos a poner en el hueco.
So what they're doing now is they're cutting. This is in a wire basket, and it's in a wire basket to hold the soil in the roots while it's being transported from the where it was grown to where we're planting it.
La razón por la que le ponen el alambre es para aguantar el sistema radicular y la tierra junta para que no se desarme cuando el árbol está siendo transportado.
And now they're going to be removing the burlap. All of this is the metal doesn't biodegrade, so you don't want to leave it in the soil. And the burlap will prevent will take a long time to biodegrade, so it will prevent the roots from spreading out. The burlap is going to prevent the roots from spreading out, and the metal doesn't biodegrade, so that's why you're getting rid of that.
La razón por la que le sacamos la envoltura es porque es hecho de material sintético y las raíces no crecen, no lo pasan las raíces, solo lo que hacemos lo sacamos y la malla también, la malla de alambre, si no la sacamos eso va a estrangular el árbol.
Now we're going to get to see what the roots look like.
Ahora vamos a ver cómo las raíces se ven.
And the roots are the most important part of the tree, because this is where they get their minerals and their nourishment is from the soil.
Las raíces es la parte más importante del árbol, porque ahí es donde el árbol absorbe los minerales y los nutrientes que lo van a hacer crecer. Es todo un proceso plantar el árbol.
So it's definitely easier with a little one.
Es más fácil plantar árboles pequeños.
But if you're lucky enough to have these guys work for you and come and help you, then it's not so bad.
Si tenés 5 personas para plantar los que te ayuden, no hay problema.
This is a black gum tree, which is a really excellent native tree for our area. And it actually takes a variety of soil conditions, and it's you can have it in a wetter area or upland like this.
Let's look for the
come over here. Now we're going to look for the root zone. Ready? We're gonna start taking it apart, or do you want to put it in first?
No, so we see if we see if we are the right height.
Okay, you want to say that in Spanish?
Lo que estamos haciendo ahora estamos buscando donde empieza el sistema radicular, el primer aro de las raíces. Así sabemos si estamos a la profundidad adecuada. Aquí tenemos una raíz.
So can you tell us what you're looking for?
We're looking for the root zone. So quite often when you buy a tree from the nursery, it has gotten a lot of dirt over it over time, so it's actually higher than it should be planted. What you need to do, there's a transition zone between the trunk and the root, and you'll notice the root flares out a little bit, and then the trunk flares, and then you see the roots. You want this to be ground level, not where this not just because you bought it at this, it looks like it's ground level, it should be where the roots start. So you're not suffocating.
So lo que estamos buscando aquí es donde están las raíces, donde empiezan las raíces en la base del tronco. So la zona de transición donde termina el tronco y empiezan las raíces. Porque cuando el árbol está, fue plantado, la tierra se va acumulando y queda plantado muy profundo. La profundidad que el árbol tiene que ser plantado es donde empiezan las raíces, no donde se ve la tierra. Por eso hay que buscar las raíces y esa va a ser la profundidad del árbol.
So now we're going to get it in the hole and then look at the roots, correct? Because
yeah.
We don't want to take all the dirt out. So in this case, because we don't want the dirt to fall all the way off before we put in there, we're going to get it in there and then we're going to start looking to see how the roots are.
Okay? So ahora vamos a poner el árbol en el hueco y ahí vamos a buscar dónde están las raíces y abrirlo un poco. Okay?
And this is a very good demonstration right here. We're going to make sure before we put it in that the hole is the right depth. So you want the hole to be as deep as where the root zone starts to the bottom of the root ball. No deeper, because what will happen is if you make it deeper, the tree might sink down and then eventually become too low.
Lo que estamos haciendo ahora es asegurarlo de que el hueco no es demasiado profundo, porque la profundidad, como dijimos anteriormente, es donde empiezan las raíces, no allá arriba. I think the low
is good. It's too deep. Okay. So Miguel is gonna or
demonstrate.
So checking twice is always good.
Tierra en el hueco, hay que apretarla para que después el árbol no se hunda. Good. Lo que vamos a hacer ahora es sacar un poco de tierra para ver que las raíces estén bien. Lo que estamos buscando es que no haya ninguna raíz, como dijimos anteriormente, que esté en la forma de círculo. Porque eso lo que hace es va a crecer y va a estrangular el árbol.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us what you're looking at, that you're checking?
So we want to make sure that there's no roots that are circulating, and what they call that is girdling roots, because what'll happen if it's circulating here, then when this tree gets bigger, it'll strangle the tree. So we want to make sure the roots are going out, but not around.
Como dije anteriormente, lo que estamos haciendo es asegurarnos de que las raíces estén derechas hacia afuera, no en círculo. Y cuando están en forma circular, cuando el árbol crece, esas raíces pueden estrangular el árbol.
Straighten it out so that we're sending it in the right direction. That looks better already. Miguel fixed it. There you go. Now he really fixed it.
Lo que estamos haciendo es la raíz que estaba en forma de círculo la ponemos derecho hacia afuera, entonces va a crecer de la forma correcta.
And this would be another one over here that's coming back towards this way. So we would just want to make sure when we put the dirt in that we're encouraging this to go in the right direction.
So, antes que ponemos la tierra, tenemos que asegurarnos que las raíces estén en la dirección correcta.
So now, what's really important is you want your tree to be straight. So we need to step back and make sure it looks straight on all sides.
Ahora lo que vamos a tratar de que el árbol quede derecho. Eso lo que hacemos es nos retiramos un poco y nos aseguramos de que estamos perfectos.
Now, you'll also notice that when the root ball, the color of the dirt looks much different than the dirt that's here. So see this? You can see here. See the difference? So this was grown elsewhere in a different type of, this is actually more clay. So what you want to do is you want to, when you're scooping the dirt back in, you want to sort of mix it in a little bit. So it's not so much around the roots as one particular foreign soil, not a soil that was here. So as they're doing this, they're going to start incorporating.
Lo que estamos haciendo ahora es, como pueden ver, la diferencia entre la tierra del árbol con la tierra donde lo estamos plantando. Esa tierra es más arcillosa. Lo mezclamos para que el árbol no tenga una reacción hacia el nuevo suelo.
So Miguel, would you want to put some water in now once they get this point? So we're going to put some water in now. A lot of times people wait till it's completely planted, but we're experiencing a very dry period, and also remembering that a lot of roots were cut off this tree, so it does have a bit of a shock to it. So this isn't making it feel a little better.
Lo que estamos haciendo ahora, le estamos poniendo agua antes de tapar el árbol, antes de tapar las raíces totalmente. De esta manera las raíces van a agarrar más humedad, pues se le cortaron muchas raíces y va a crecer mejor y también va a sacar el aire que hay entre la tierra.
That's good. That's good. Because now it should go down a little bit. So now the bottom roots are wetter, where if you were just watering from the top, you might not get the water all the way to the bottom. Because it's pretty deep here.
Y la razón por qué se hace esto es porque así las raíces de abajo, de la parte de abajo del tronco, agarran agua también, porque si solo le ponemos agua cuando está tapado, las raíces más profundas no van a agarrar agua.
¿Tienes un clipper? Puedes clipper esos off. Ok.
¿Qué es en el paquete?
So the most important part of the root system is this very fine part of the root. This is where most of the nutrients get uptake from the soil. So you just, you know, you always want to be careful not to damage the roots as best possible. So you're doing it as gently as possible.
La parte más importante de las raíces son estas raíces finas. Esas son las raíces que absorben los nutrientes para el árbol. Entonces hay que tener cuidado cuando se está plantando de no destruir esas raíces.
So one very important thing to note here is you'll notice that we're only putting back the soil that was taken out of the hole, and we're not putting in any peat moss, we're not putting any fertilizer in. We really want to use just the natural soil so that the tree starts coming into this area, which is a different soil than where the root ball is.
Como pueden ver, algo muy importante es que no estamos poniendo fertilizante o peat moss. O nada, solo la tierra que va a estar aquí, donde la tierra que estaba aquí, donde el árbol se va a plantar.
Also, fertilizer can be too strong for the roots, and the roots, you know, as they've been cut and they're kind of a little bit in transplant shock. So it could, the fertilizer, particularly if it's too much or the wrong kind, could burn the roots.
La razón por la que no usamos fertilizante es porque las raíces fueron cortadas y si ponemos fertilizante puede quemar las raíces.
And this is a good time to check the branches since it was tied up. Some of them might be might need to be untangled.
Cuando lo que hay que hacer también es desenredar las ramas que quedan, como el árbol estaba atado. Hay que abrir a las ramas y darle el espacio correspondiente.
Also, do not want to prune at this time because again, the plant it's in shock, or can be in shock because you've taken it from its cozy home somewhere else and you brought it here and needs an adjustment period. So you don't prune it until one full growing season has passed.
So recomienda no podarlo, no cortar ninguna rama hasta que pase un año de que ha crecido el árbol. La razón es porque a lo que fue arrancado del lugar y se cortaron tantas las raíces, el árbol no va a reaccionar bien a la poda.
So after a full season has passed, you might want to look and see if there's crossing branches. That would be something that you'd want to prune. Or if there was a double leader, which this looks like it's actually trying to have two top points. So you would make one shorter. So on this tree, you're going to have to use a long, you know, pole cutter. Just make one shorter so it doesn't have two leaders. If it has two leaders, what'll happen is it's going to make a big V crotch, and in a storm, it could break.
Cuando después que pase un año de crecimiento del árbol, se recomienda cortarlos a los branches que estén cruzados o muy cerca, pero lo más importante es la punta no tiene que haber dos ramas saliendo en B, porque eso es lo que va a hacer que cuando haya tormenta o algo, en esa B se puede romper en la punta del árbol y ahí crecería desviado.
Looking good, right? So So you'll notice they're making a berm around here. So the goal is to have no grass or weeds in the area where that root ball was. So the root ball, you know, was about to out to here. So you're going to make sure.
Yeah, we think it'll.
Yeah, you're going to make sure that this stays without grass and without weeds in this area. So the grass. Never plant grass right up to the tree trunk, because what happens is if you get a shallow rain, the roots of the grass will take all the water, and the water won't get to the roots of the tree.
Okay, la razón por la que estamos haciendo así es para que cuando se pone el agua esté ahí donde está el sistema radicular, las raíces. So, y no plantar, no dejar que la grama, el pasto, crezca hacia arriba donde están las raíces, porque eso absorbería el agua. Cuando tenemos una lluvia pequeña, el pasto absorbería el agua antes que el árbol.
So the water doesn't all run to one side.
Trata de que esté a nivel, así el agua no se va solo en un lado. Haciendo algo, está apretando para que no haya ningún espacio con aire entre las raíces.
Those are love pats.
Un poco de amor por el árbol.
Ready?
I think agua. So. Do we forget anything?
I don't know.
What do you think, guys?
Me parece good.
Creo que no nos olvidamos de nada.
All right, so here comes a really important part. Now we're going to water. So for any new planting, you want to make sure the soil stays moist. It doesn't have to be sopping wet, but it needs to stay moist for the at least the first year. When a tree this size, you should be monitoring it for up to 5 years. You water it until mid-fall, and then it should be good in the winter. If we get a very dry, warm winter, you'd want to come out and give some water again so it doesn't dry out. Quite often when you see people plant Christmas trees and they die the next year, it's because the winter was dry, not the rain in the summer.
Todos plantamos un árbol así, hay que mantener tratar de que el suelo se mantenga húmedo, no muy mojado, pero sí húmedo, hasta el otoño más o menos.
So one of your best tools you can get is a rain gauge. Of course, I'm just going to show it here and right here. You wouldn't put it underneath where the leaves of the tree are, because then it would not be an accurate assessment. So you put it a little further out from the tree, and you can tell if it's rained, and you need an inch of rainwater a week to keep the tree hydrated. So if you don't get that inch of rain, then you need to water it. But if it's a new tree like this, you probably need to do more than the inch, and just make sure the ground stays moist. If you have any question, I have a really good soil tester, and I'm not going to put it in the wet water because it's not down yet, but you would just put your finger in the soil and it should be able to go all the way in, and that's that'll tell you that you have enough water, or should have enough water, and it's free.
si se puede conseguir un medidor de lluvia, pluviómetro es el nombre, pero para hacerlo más sencillo, para medir la lluvia. Para un árbol así, precisaría una pulgada de lluvia por semana. So, ahí tenemos la diferencia. Si no llueve, tenemos que regarlo. Y lo que yo estaba demostrando es que una manera de medir es si se puede poner el dedo en la tierra, quiere decir que está suficientemente suave o que tiene suficientemente agua para el árbol también.
So the last thing I'll mention is if you're planting near in a place that had a house before or you're near a foundation, you might want to check the pH. And if you need any information on how to do that or any other questions that you have about planting a tree or any of your other landscaping questions, you can call Cooperative Extension of Westchester and they will be able to help you. So just look up Cornell Cooperative Extension Westchester, and they're there as part of your tax dollars. They're there to help you with any of your gardening questions.
Okay, uno de los problemas que puede haber cuando se planta árboles cerca de una casa o donde hubieron foundation es la acidez del suelo, puede ser muy alta. Que hay manera de analizar la acidez, hay manera de analizar el suelo para ver la acidez, el nivel de acidez, y ellos los pueden ayudar.
All right.
Okay.
Done.
Good job, guys. You help.